Coming up next on ATETV. Wind energy technology.
I don't fit in a box real well, and so there was just something about being outside and being able to scale those towers.
Community colleges and apprenticeships.
And Benjamin Franklin felt that apprentices made good citizens. The college is really founded on those principles.
And rapid prototyping.
It's going straight from your idea to the creation without having to take too much time in between.
Now on ATETV. From across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. Whether you're environmentally conscious, love working outdoors, or simply looking for a job that's hands-on and in high demand, community colleges offer courses that will prepare you for a career in renewable energy.
I'm Stacey Brandt. I'm going to school at Laramie County Community College.
This would be your pressure gauge for the pump itself.
And I'm in the wind energy technology program.
If you look inside the connection points.
I'm not a hugely technical person, but everything inside me went, that's what I want to do when I grow up.
It's an inexhaustible supply of energy. Here in Wyoming, the wind always blows.
I don't fit in a box real well, and so there was just something neat about being outside and being able to scale those towers. Before I started school, I was a stay-at-home mom. I have two kids, and I stayed at home for about 8 years. Went through a divorce, decided that I didn't want to work at McDonald's forever and try to support two children that way, so I came back to school.
The folks that are coming into this wind energy program are looking at this as something that they see as an important thing for our society and our environment.
It's renewable energy. The wind part of it is hands-on, it's very technical, and I love the hands-on part of it because I learned so much better that way. My son is 9. He thinks the whole thing is cool, that I'm going to be working on the big wind turbines. I think that if people find something that they're truly interested in, go for it, because having that interest and that desire and that passion makes it so much easier to do, to get up and do every day and to get through those challenges. I am very optimistic about my future. I have got nowhere to go from here except for up.
Stacey is definitely headed for a great career in the wind energy technology field. If you think you may be interested in renewable energy, be sure to check out your local community college. Want to learn about different technologies in a community-based environment and begin a well-paying and exciting technology career? Then be sure to check out opportunities like these at your local community college.
Our college was founded in 1908 with money that was given in the will of Benjamin Franklin.
And Benjamin Franklin's donation was to build an institution that would be used to train apprentices, just as he had been.
And Benjamin Franklin felt that apprentices made good citizens. This college is really founded on those principles. We work very hard at creating a sense of community among our students. Part of that is to work intensely with the student and to make that student feel that they're supported in many different ways.
This is like a second home to me, and I get advice from my instructors.
The students, faculty, staff are able to communicate with one another.
The staff is really good. They're always ready and willing to help, so the learning environment is really good.
There's all sorts of things a student might study here. There are industrial technologies, automotive, electrical, computer, and architectural technology. Then there are the engineering technologies, and those involve electronic engineering technology, medical electronic engineering technology, mechanical engineering technology, and computer engineering technology. What we do is we help students build the communication skills, the applied math skills, and the problem-solving skills that we know will be central to their being successful in one of their technology fields.
When it comes to HVAC, I can take on any guy.
Certainly the goal of every program is to make sure that the project students are working on, that the equipment that they are working with every day is current so that our students feel confident about their own employment.
The environment here is really good too. For example, like just the basic refrigeration system we have on the wall, that's the stuff that's in the field. So the hands-on is really good.
All of our programs include components that are very much hands-on. And because they're hands-on technologies, they tend not to be the technologies that will get outsourced in the future.
One of the things that we think is increasing in terms of the value of our education and why students would want to come to this college is the knowledge that their jobs are going to be out there waiting for them, as opposed to the anxieties of going through an education and wondering what's at the end of this.
Community colleges will expand your skills in communications, technology, and problem solving, and will enable you to find a secure, high-paying career in today's technical fields. Starting your education at a community college is a smart and affordable way to get your career on the fast track, almost as fast as these rapid prototype machines can print up three-dimensional designs. Check it out.
Do some silicone casting. Let's talk a little bit about different kinds of silicone.
This is the rapid prototype modeling class. When people used to design a product, they used to have to like make it by hand and carve it out or like build it separately, but now this is the way that we can do it in a computer and do the whole design digitally, three-dimensionally.
Okay, open the door.
And then print it out layer by layer, which would give you a solid model in the end. Going straight from your idea to the creation without having to take too much time in between.
This silicone, you're gonna get air into it. What the vacuum's gonna do is it's gonna pull the air out of it so when you cast it against your model, you won't have any air bubbles in it.
The reason I'm in a community college is it is more about the hands-on, using the product, learning how to use them, and the trial and error of maybe getting them wrong to figure out how to use it properly.
So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna turn the vacuum on.
At first, it's a little intimidating to use such expensive equipment because you don't want to be the guy who drops a piece in there and there goes a $250,000 machine because your part drooped.
Now, see the bubbles already coming to the top?
My goal is to transfer to University of California, Irvine for aerospace engineering. You get to build things and your creations have a chance of changing the future. Companies are looking for this right now because it is more or less the wave of the future. And so me knowing how to do it puts me in a better spot than a lot of people.
If you're interested in rapid prototyping, be sure to look into your local community college for design and manufacturing programs that utilize the latest technology. For more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at atetv.org. Thanks for watching.